Hello and welcome to this video on MMIC design flow in ADS. My name is Jack Sifri, and in this video I will demonstrate ADS Desktop DRC. This is our complete MMIC desktop design flow in ADS. It starts from top-level system specs and ends with successful delivery of a MMIC in its final environment, packaged, inserted in a module, and mounted on a board. After having completed your layout and verified it with Momentum 3D Planar EM simulation, the next step in the design flow is to run DRC, Design Rule Check, on your layout prior to submitting it to the MMIC Foundry. And that is because we want to validate that our design complies with all the design rules given by the Foundry. As you see here, ADS has various DRC tools available to designers. ADS has links to Caliber and Assura DRC tools, and there is also a TriQuint mail DRC link which allows designers to email in their designs to TriQuint Foundry, who verifies the designs and gives back the results via email. But this video demo will focus only on ADS Desktop DRC, which is included in the new ADS layout and can be run easily and at any time during the MMIC design phase. Why Desktop DRC? That is because DRC licenses can be expensive, and most companies have only a few DRC licenses that are shared by many users. So with Desktop DRC, there is no need to wait for a remote DRC license to become available, and no DRC license denials. Now you can run DRC early in your design cycle at any time and as often as you want, so there will be no surprises at the end. Desktop DRC is easily accessible from the ADS Layout MMIC toolbar as shown here. DRC is a tool that determines if your MMIC has satisfied certain rules given by the Foundry along with their process design kit. Here are a few examples of basic design rules. There are minimum width rules, minimum spacing rules between lines or other elements. There are enclosure rules that specify a minimum spacing an object must be enclosed within another. And there are lengths to width ratio rules on air bridges for reliability reasons. And of course, there are many other rules for any given foundry process. The DRC viewer in ADS lists all the errors that are found from ADS Desktop DRC and accurately provides to you the X and Y coordinates of each error and zoom on it. For example, in this low noise amplifier design, I selected the error via to via minimum spacing rule, and the DRC viewer gave me the X and Y coordinate of that error and zoomed right on it as shown here. Now please allow me to demo this for you in ADS. This is a two-stage MMIC power amplifier designed for LTE applications, and I want to run DRC on it. Once ADS Desktop DRC is invoked, I select the design kit that I have used on my design. The rule files loads in automatically, and then I select which rule file I want to use. And I click on Run. Within a few seconds, the DRC checks the whole design and provides me with a summary of errors, as shown here. As we see, there are 13 errors that I must fix before I proceed any further. And here's a list of these errors along with the rules that were violated. The DRC viewer opens up automatically, and all the errors with their X and Y coordinates are displayed as shown here. Notice the auto zoom box has been checked here. So when I click on any error, for example, here we have a rule that specifies that the spacing between ground via and source via must be greater than 60 micron. When I select that error, the layout automatically zooms on that error as shown here. Here's another error. The spacing between the border and the via layer must be greater than 30 microns, and we violated this rule as shown here. I want to point out here that many of my 13 errors relate to these two errors that I have just shown you, because the vias and the pads consist of many stacked layers, and each one of these layers failed to meet the rule. To fix the via to via spacing error, I can push into that specific subnetwork and modify my layout, or I can take advantage of the edit in place feature in ADS, which allows me to edit the subnetwork while staying at the top level design view. Let me show you how. So what I'm about to do here is to lengthen the shunt vertical line by 50 microns, and to compensate for this length, I must reduce the horizontal line by the same amount. This modification would separate the ground and source vias from each other by more than 60 micron and will help me meet the DRC rule. Next, I want to move the pad a little bit away from the border in order to meet the border to pad minimum separation rule of 30 microns. Now let me run DRC again. Notice here my original 13 errors are now reduced to 2 errors. These 2 errors are highlighted with yellow marking as shown. Let me go ahead and zoom on them. Okay, here's the first one. There is a metal zero in blue color to border separation error as shown here. I must have more clearance away from the border. And here's another metal 1 to metal 1 minimum spacing error shown in green. I must have more separation between metal 1 and metal 1. I went ahead and fixed these 2 errors, and now I want to rerun DRC again. So now we see that we have 0 errors and our design meets all DRC rules given by the foundry, and now we can proceed to the next step in the design flow. So the beauty of ADS Desktop DRC is there is no waiting for DRC results. It is easily accessible within ADS layout and helps shorten your design cycle. Also, your design IP never leaves your desktop. Desktop DRC runs very fast and allows you to check your design directly in ADS design environment and at any time and as often as you want during your design phase. Before ending this demo, I would also love to share with you another 2 useful tools available in ADS. The first one is the Physical Connectivity Engine, which checks if your design is physically connected correctly and there are no unexpected opens or shorts in your layout. Let me show you. You can access the Physical Connectivity Engine either from the Layout toolbar or from the Tools pull-down menu, as shown here. Once activated, you can click anywhere on the design, and the tool will highlight all the elements that are physically connected together. For example, by clicking on this drain bias line, you can see that the physical connection goes to both drains. Notice how it stops at the capacitor in this feedback path between the drain and the gate. The second useful and favorite feature in ADS is the 3D Layout Viewer. You can also launch it from the Layout toolbar as shown here. The 3D Viewer gives you added flexibility and allows you to visually inspect your designs for any physical connectivity errors with 3D zooming and cut plane features. Let me show you some of these highlights and features. Here is the 3D view of the MMIC PA. You can rotate it and you can zoom on it using your computer mouse. By using the Z-axis expansion feature, you can expand the vertical dimension, which allows you to easily inspect and verify all vertical connections. By using the cut plane features, you can sweep your view using any plane and in any directions for a complete inspection. For a free evaluation of ADS and for more information on MMIC design flow in ADS, please visit these web pages. Thank you for watching this video.